The Three Wishes. There was once a poor man who had a pretty woman as his wife. One winter evening, as they sat by the fire, they talked of the happiness of their neighbors who were richer than they. Said the wife, "If it were in my power to have what I wish, I would soon be happier than all of them." "So would I too," said the husband. "I wish fairies were real, and we had one with us now who was kind enough to grant me what I would ask." At that instant, they saw a beautiful lady in their room. She told them, "I am a fairy, and I promise to grant you the first three wishes you shall wish. But be careful, after you have wished for three things, I will not grant even one wish more." The fairy disappeared, and the man and his wife were much perplexed and didn't know what to do. "For me, if it is left up to my choice," said the wife, "I know very well what I shall wish for. I'm not wishing yet, but I think nothing is as good as to be pretty, to be rich, and to have people think I'm elegant." But the husband answered, "With all these things, you might still get sick and worry and die young. It would be much smarter to wish for health, for cheerfulness, and for a long life." "But what good is a long life if we're poor?" said the wife. "It would only make us miserable for a longer time." "In truth, the fairy should have promised us a dozen wishes, for there are at least a dozen things I want." "That's true," said the husband, "but let's take our time. Let's think it over from now till morning, and then decide the three most important things to wish for. And when we've agreed, then we can wish." "I'll think all night," said the wife. "Meanwhile, let us put more wood on the fire, for it is very cold." She took the fire tongs to put on more wood, and seeing there were a great many red coals in the fire already burning, she said without thinking, "Here's a nice fire. I wish we had a long black sausage for our supper. We could roast it easily." She had hardly said these words when down the chimney came tumbling a long, thick black sausage. "Oh, you silly woman," said her husband. "Here's a fine wish indeed. Now we have only two left. For my part, I am so upset that I wish this black sausage were hanging from the tip of your nose." The man soon perceived that he was sillier than his wife, for at this second wish, up flew the black sausage and stuck so fast to the tip end of his poor wife's nose that however much they tried to tug and jerk and even cut it off with scissors, there was no way they could get it off. "I'm a fool," she said, "but you are a wicked man for wishing that sausage stuck tight to my nose." "My dear," answered the husband, "I did not think of it. But what shall we do? I have been thinking about wishing for great riches, and suppose we could make a golden suitcase to hide the sausage." "What?" shouted the wife. "Not at all. I should kill myself if I had to live with this sausage dangling from my nose." "You listen to me. We still have one wish to make. Let me make it, or I shall instantly throw myself out of the window." At that, she ran and opened the window. But her husband, who loved his wife very much, called out, "Wait, dear wife, you can wish for whatever you like." "Well," said the wife, "my wish is that the sausage may drop off." At that instant, the sausage dropped off, and the wife, who was smarter than she had seemed, said to her husband, "The fairy has done this to us on purpose." And the fairy was right. If we became rich, we might find ourselves far more unhappy than we are now. Believe me, husband, let us wish for nothing and take things as it shall please God to send them. In the meantime, let us make a supper from our sausage, since that's all that remains of our wishes. The husband thought his wife judged right. They had a happy supper and never bothered themselves again about the things which before they had always wished for.